Welcome to part two of Area with Polar Coordinates. We'll look at another example on how to determine the area of a region bounded by a polar curve. On this example, we want to determine the area of the region bounded by r equals 1 plus cosine 2 theta. Here's the graph of our polar curve. And as I mentioned in the previous video, it's also helpful to graph this on the rectangular coordinate plane, where the y-axis would be r and the x-axis would be theta. And this is very helpful to determine the limits of integration on our definite integral. So just to review, when graphed on the coordinate plane, the period would be 2 pi divided by 2, or pi radians, as we see here. And this 1 here also shifts the graph up 1 unit. So this allows us to determine what the radius would be given a specific angle from 0 to pi radians. So we take a look at this graph on the coordinate plane. Notice that when theta is equal to 0, r is equal to 2. So when theta is equal to 0, we're at this point here. So what I think might be a good strategy is to determine the area of this region here, and then multiply it by 4 to determine the total area bounded by this curve. So if we take a look at this graph again, notice that when theta is equal to 0, r is 2, and then when theta is equal to pi over 2, the radius is equal to 0. So between 0 and pi over 2, we would actually be tracing out this piece of the curve, which is exactly what we need to determine the area of this yellow region. So our limits of integration will be from 0 to pi over 2, and then we'll multiply that definite integral by 4 to find the total area bounded by this polar curve. So what we're seeing here is that this piece of the curve on the rectangular coordinate plane corresponds to this piece of the curve in polar form. Let's go ahead and set this up, and then we'll verify it with the graphing calculator as well. So we're going to have 4 times 1 half. We're multiplying this by 4 to find the total area bounded by this polar curve. The definite integral from 0 to pi over 2 of r squared d theta. Well, r is 1 plus cosine 2 theta. And we'll square this. Again, let's verify these limits of integration with the graphing calculator. Let's plus our mode key, make sure that we're in degree mode and also polar mode as we see here. We'll press y equals and then type in our equation, 1 plus cosine 2 theta. Let's make sure we have the proper window before we graph it. Press window. Notice theta goes from 0 to 360 because we're in degrees. And I'm going to change the theta step to 1.5. Now before we graph this, let's go ahead and press zoom option 4 for z decimal. Notice we're getting a nice graph of this polar curve. Now if we press trace, we can see exactly what piece of the graph is traced out from 0 to pi over 2 radians, which would be 90 degrees. So we can see at 0, right here at this point where we said when r is equal to 2, as we increase theta, we can see which piece of the graph we're tracing out. And we'll notice that when theta is equal to 90 degrees, we're back at the pole, as we see here. So this verifies our limits of integration. So we're going to have 2, and we'll have to FOIL this, so we'll have 1 plus 2 cosine 2 theta plus cosine squared 2 theta. Now for me, I think it's going to be easier to keep track of this if we go ahead and bring this 2 into the definite integral, and then we'll apply the power reducing formula to cosine squared 2 theta. So we'll have 2 plus 4 cosine 2 theta plus 2 cosine squared 2 theta. So we know by now we do have to apply the power reducing formula for cosine squared 2 theta. So let's go ahead and do that. So we'll have cosine 4 theta . So let's go ahead and simplify this and then combine this one here with this 2 here on the next screen. So we'll have 3 plus 4 cosine 2 theta plus cosine 4 theta. Now we're ready to integrate. Notice we are going to have to perform u substitution when integrating cosine 2 theta and integrating cosine 4 theta. So we'll have 3 theta plus 4 times, we'd have 1 half sine 2 theta. And then similarly for this one, we'll have 1 fourth sine 4 theta. We evaluate this all at pi over 2 and 0. We'll first replace theta with pi over 2. So we'll have 3 pi over 2. This would be 2 times sine pi. Well, sine pi is 0, plus 1 fourth sine 2 pi, which is also 0. And then when theta is equal to 0, these are all 0. So this definite integral is equal to 3 pi over 2, which tells us the total area bounded by this polar curve is equal to 3 pi over 2 square units. Okay, in part 3 we'll take a look at one more example on how to determine the area bounded by a polar curve. That'll do it for this video.